Atreus, follow me.
Sorry, got distracted.
Oh.
I need that alchemist for something I'm stewing up for you. If you're smart, you'll find him. What's it gonna be this time? Make you something? Is that all there is?
Hey, where's your beast of burden?
What do you mean? I ate her. Fat bits of her out just a while ago.
What is wrong with you?
What? Her milk ran dry.
She was your friend.
Then she'll be happy I'm so well fed. Shit bricks, boy, you got a real sentimental streak, know that? Don't get yourself confused out there. I'm getting back to it.
Atreus, to me!
I'm coming!
Strong, Atreus. Stay focused and look for a weak point.
Yes, sir.
Stay quiet. Make no sudden movement. Stay quiet. Make no sudden movement.
The rest of them?
Ashes, most likely.
The Soul Eater got him. I guess we should bring this back to Brock.
Read it.
Sir. These runes were written fast. Spells out. Ejim Staney. I don't know that one.
We will ask the blue one.
So now you're interested?
We found his alchemist. A reward was promised.
What'd you find?
Your alchemist.
I'm sorry, Brock. The hand is all we could find. Still wearing the ring. There was a soul eater inside. And, well, it must have burned away the rest of him.
Suppose you'll still be wanting some compensation, huh?
Naturally.
Naturally, he says. Miani Ferruxy. I'll take a closer look at this here ring. Maybe Anvari left a bit of magic inside before he groped.
Dwarves can do that?
Sure, dwarves and magic jewels is like flies and pig lips. Supple ones.
Ugh. I'm not as interested as I thought.
Come back soon with more crap you found.
Come, boy.
Ugh. Oh. Got another story?
Very well. There was the story of the mother crab, who scolded her son. She told him he should walk forward, in pride, not sideways as he always did.
But she's a crab too. He should say, sure, I'll walk forward as soon as you show me how.
Yes, he did say that. That was the story.
I got it. Serpent's even over here. I told you he's big. We can dock the boat here. Hey, look! A torch!
A torch is built with wood. That is a brazier.
A brazier. Looks like there's something written on it. Want me to read it? Kvekia.
kill them.
What is that?
A spirit.
It's talking to us.
And it hears you as well. Be shy now.
You're dead?
You're very perceptive and reckless. Take caution when lighting these braziers. Sailor and Hellwalkers will swarm to the flames like moths. I assume we have you to thank for freeing us from a watery grave.
Us?
Other spirits. The Lake of Nine is full of them. Most are able to move on from this realm. But we, lucky few, are stuck here in Midgard until our affairs are in order. Perhaps you can help them as well.
We have no desire to help you, Spirit.
Ah, but you already have. I only wished to see the sky again. Farewell.
Disappear.
Come, let us not be distracted.
What do we need here? So, I guess we should keep an eye out for other spirits.
What did I say about distractions?
But it sounds like they needed help.
They are spirits, boy. Dead things. They have no needs. Only wants.
It feels wrong to ignore them.
You will get over these feelings.
Mom would have wanted to help them.
What was that, boy?
Nothing.
I thought as much.
Any more short and purposeful stories for me?
Very well. There is a tale about a woodsman. He asked. the trees of the forest for a branch to make a handle for his axe. But instead, the trees gave him a young sapling so they could keep their limbs. The woodsman made his axe, and then he returned and chopped down the oldest trees in the forest.
Just because trees are old doesn't mean they're smart.
Boy.
Oh.
Brock, what do you know about the serpent in the lake?
I know he's too damn big.
All right.
Now you're talking.
Oh.
Next time, I guess.